temperatures all across the board running a bit lower compared to this time yesterday. Here's the reason why. We've got to look offshore. All of this widespread cloud cover, that's a visual indicator that the marine layer is not only widespread, but it's getting relatively deep. So the layer of cool air at the coast is stacking up. That's one major ingredient we need for cool air at this time of the year. And of course, with the afternoon sun, it's moderately cool. But here's how deep that marine layer is, right around 2,000 feet at this point. When it gets down to around 1,000 feet or below, that's when the Delta breeze really kind of loses its impact for Sacramento County in particular. But now that we've got that deep marine layer, we've got the winds coming onshore. They've backed off this afternoon, but they'll pick up again here in an hour or so. And that Delta breeze really helping to keep things feeling fresh in the evenings and into the overnights, and it's leading to afternoons that are at least a few degrees lower than what we saw the last couple of days when the Delta breeze wasn't quite as effective. So here's Futurecast showing that onshore flow, especially for the San Joaquin Valley. It'll pick up in a couple of hours and then it'll back off again overnight. But look at the wind arrows here. Notice even though the winds are light tomorrow, the wind is still coming up out of the south through the Sacramento Valley. It's coming through the north through the San Joaquin Valley. That should help to keep temperatures for most places below 100 degrees, just barely so, but still temperatures in the upper 90s tomorrow afternoon, and then in the evening, once again, it's right back in to the Delta breeze. So what to know through Saturday? We'll have some really nice mornings in the valley. It'll be a little milder into the foothills where that onshore flow doesn't quite reach. Afternoons will be very warm, but it's the kind of warmth that we're used to at this point in the season. Upper 90s, couple spots around 100 degrees. We'll start with the coast. This will, of course, be the mildest spot tomorrow with temperatures in the upper 80s for Fairfield into the East Bay. Low 70s in San Francisco, where, again, that cloud cover will be a little bit stubborn for the first half of the day. Should see some afternoon sunshine, though. San Joaquin Valley, again, the onshore flow helping temperatures start in the upper 50s to low 60s. Afternoon highs, upper 90s in most places. Turlock may just barely get to 100 degrees for an hour or two tomorrow afternoon. Spot like Roseville or Folsom may just barely hit 100, but notice plenty of 90s from Sacramento into Elk Grove. Morning temperatures starting in the lower 60s. Into the foothills, mid to upper 60s. Placerville at the airport may just start at 70 degrees. Afternoon highs in the low to mid 90s. And finally, in the Sierra, starting in the 30s around Truckee and Tahoe, ending with temperatures in the low to mid 80s. 7-day forecast shows, again, upper 90s to around 100 degrees. That's a little bit of a change. Fewer numbers compared to what we were showing on the 7-day yesterday.
That's good. Yes.
But in reality, the overall feel of the forecast is the same.
Okay. Thank you, Heather.
Yep.